Good morning, Cubs. Happy Sabbath. We're just so happy that you have joined us once again for Cubs Corner. I'm here with Auntie M in Auntie M's classroom, which is pretty cool and really nice. Yes, she'll love visitors, but of course. But for our first song, now it is going to be...
I've got the joy down in my heart. I've got the joy down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. I've got the joy down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I have the love of Jesus in my heart, down in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy. Jesus in my heart. I've got the peace that passes understanding down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. I have the peace that passes understanding down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart to say. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I have the love of Jesus in my heart, down in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy.
All right, guys, so for our second song, we're going to do a song Auntie M really likes. I mean, she likes all the songs, but this one's the banana song.
I like bananas. I think the mangoes are sweet. I like papaya.
What?
Papayas? But nothing can beat that sweet love of God.
It's sweet, but then
it turned sour.
I took him in and received his power. A 1, a 2, a 3.
I like bananas. I think the mangoes are sweet. I like papaya.
What? Papaya?
But nothing.
The sweet love of God. The sweet love of God. So for our last song, we're going to sing some fantastic lyrics, which are, "My God is so great and so strong and so mighty."
My God is so great, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so great, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are His, the rivers are His, the stars are His handiwork too. God is so great, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do
for you.
My God is so great, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do
for you.
My God is so great, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are His, the rivers are His, the stars.
What's up, guys? We're still here in Auntie M's classroom, as you can see, but now we're sitting in lawn chairs, which is pretty cool. We're so happy that you guys can join us once again. And Auntie M, how are you doing?
I'm doing really well. It's the first week that school is out.
Summer is officially here. Woo! That's so cool, being a teacher. You know, us pastors, we have to work year round. So it's all good though. We love you guys and we're so happy to do this. But today, before we start off, we're gonna talk about a subject that, you know, it's always interesting. I don't know if you guys have ever thought about it before. But before we start, I want Auntie M to read our verse for today.
Okay. So this is coming from Genesis 1:27. It says, "So God created mankind in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them."
Man, I love that verse. Mm. I think that's a very, very powerful verse that, you know, Auntie M, you and I, we were created in his image. We're pretty much alike, right? But yeah. But we don't look the same. Isn't that weird though?
Well, we have two arms and two hands. But yeah, if you look at our faces, we don't look related.
I don't think so. I mean, what's your heritage, Auntie M?
My heritage is Filipino, little bit of Spanish, and Chinese. We had a Chinese pirate who married into our family.
No way!
Yeah, that's... discovered that late in the game, and all this time it turns out that my last name wasn't really my last name. The Chinese pirate married a Filipino woman, and he changed his last name so any problems with her marrying a Chinese pirate.
Wow, very interesting. Wow, okay. You know, for myself, I think it's a little more simple, you know. I'm half Mexican and half Salvadorian, which is, in essence, is always interesting. Every time I say that, people are always wondering, because you guys will eventually learn that, you know, sometimes for some reason, the Mexicans and Salvadorians just never got to get along that much.
Oh.
Yeah, growing up. But my parents... didn't work for them, you know, and eventually here I am, and you know, I have that as part of my heritage.
They broke that barrier not getting along.
Exactly.
Nice.
But you know, growing up, it's always interesting, right? Because if you look at me and the color of my skin, I'm very dark. Right, I'm very, very dark. But my brother, on the other hand, is much more lighter skin, Hispanic. And if we look at my grandpa on my father's side, he had blue eyes, and he was a really, you know, really, really lighter skin.
So like the individual. Spanish.
Yeah, the Spanish type of, you know. So it was very interesting seeing that, you know. And I remember when I was thinking about that, I was like, wow, this is different, you know. The fact that, you know, I'm very dark skinned, and you know, he wasn't. And then, you know, with everything that's been going on, I started thinking, I'm like, you know, why are we all so different? You know, why did God create us so different in our aspects and everything we have? Because I'm good at things that you're not good at, correct?
What? I'm good at everything. I didn't realize you were going to talk about what I can't do.
You know what, Auntie? I'm right. You're absolutely right.
Let's change that. There are things that you can't do.
You're right. Kidding. No, you're absolutely right. See, kids, this is what I'm telling you. Once you get older and you become like Auntie M, trust
me,
you can
how
always.
Old? Oh, man.
Oh, man. I'm not. Late 20s.
Very good. All right,
you know,
I'll take that.
You're able to see, you're able to, you know so much more, right? Yeah, but, you know, here in my hand, I have an egg, and I'm going to get a little bit closer so you guys can see this. And my egg is brown, pretty much is almost just like me, same skin color and everything. And Auntie Anne, what do you have in your hand?
I have a white egg.
Oh, wow.
There, yes.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, nice. It's very different than yours. Look at that.
Wow, that's nice. But, you know, this week I was studying. I was researching on my free time a little bit, you know, studying as a student that I still am. And you know what I found out, Auntie Anne?
What?
That the nutrients between these two eggs are still the same.
No.
Yeah, you would think they'd be different, right? Because they're different
What? Brown rice, brown white rice. We think brown rice is healthier.
Okay, exactly.
Yeah.
But we see that they're pretty much the same. You know, some people will argue, you know, oh, it's a little bit different here and there. But most scientists believe, it may be just a couple things. Not much, though. It's pretty much almost all the same, you know. And then guess what else I found, Auntie? I found out that they're not just eggs in this color. That there's actually eggs in blue, a little bit greenish. I think you're going to have to look that up because it was probably a super cool thing that I found out. There are all these different types of colors eggs, and I was super surprised. I didn't even know that was possible. Yeah.
Okay, so you're telling me that God made eggs of more than just two colors.
Yes. I thought there was only brown and white for the longest of time. But
here they are.
Look at this.
Yeah, okay. So, here are the different colors. Isn't that so pretty? You're getting the reflection of the window, but if you look beyond that, look at that. You would think these are Easter eggs.
Exactly.
That have been colored.
That's what you would think. Oh. But in the reality, we see that just like us, God created different types of hens that create different types of colors of eggs.
Wow.
That's so much different.
Now, did you find out what actually sometimes might cause different colors?
Yeah, so, you know, from what I read, like I said, I'm not an expert, everybody, okay? I just have my theology degree and that's all. But from what I've been reading, it has to do with the calcium inside the hen when they're making it, just depending on how much they have, the levels, and then when it all comes together, then some hens, and just based on their ancestry and where they come from, they have different color eggs.
And does a hen that lays a white egg look different than a hen that lays a brown egg?
So the hen that lays a white egg is actually white, you know, in essence. But the hen that lays a brown egg is actually red.
Wow.
Yeah, but it's not always like that. There's no blue hen. I don't think I've ever seen a blue hen before. You know, but just different genetic makeup, we see that it's like that.
Okay.
But Auntie, I'm right now, I just want you to open. I want you to open the egg if we can.
Uh-oh. Okay.
I'm sorry if I get your classroom a little
bit
dirty.
That's right. Okay, let's give this a shot. Here, you want me to take the shell?
Yeah.
Or do we want to leave the shell here? Yeah, let's leave it on this side.
Yeah, just leave it on the side. See. Yeah. Okay. There you go. But now let's show them what we have here. You would think different color eggs.
Yeah.
You know, they're not going to have the same thing inside, right?
Yeah.
And you guys can see pretty much it's all the same. Different color egg, but same yolk, same egg whites, yolk, egg whites. Egg whites in the white egg. And just like that, it's kind of like us in essence, you know? So as I was saying, you know, we looked at the eggs, right? And inside it was the same. Auntie, do we have the same, what's it called again? Conclusion, there you go. Do you have the same conclusion that inside when we opened the eggs it was the same?
Yes, I was wondering if maybe there'd be like a big difference, but if you were to ask me, I probably wouldn't be able to tell which one came from which.
Okay, that's good. So, you know, now I just want to go back to the verse and read it once more, Auntie M, please.
All right, Genesis 1:27. So God created mankind in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them.
You know, as you guys know, ultimately, like Auntie M was saying in the beginning, we're all the same in essence.
Mm-hmm. Like on the inside. We all have a heart, lungs, kidneys. We have blood. It bleeds red.
It bleeds red, exactly. Our hearts are all doing the same exact thing. Our brains are all doing the same exact thing. And even though on the outside we do look different, and you know, you have friends, I'm sure, that probably look different. I have friends that are definitely different. They look different than I do, but you know, we're still all child of God. We're still children of God. We're still all. He still loves us all the same, no matter if we're male, no matter if we're female, no matter if we're dark or we're lighter. It's all the same with him. And that is something that we should also show to other people. It doesn't matter who you are or what color skin you are, where you're from. We should treat all people the same and realize, hey, yes, he may be different than me. Yes, he may talk a little bit different than me. He may have different likes than I do. He may eat different foods than I am accustomed to. But guess what? Ultimately, what are we all, Auntie M?
We're all human.
Exactly. We're all human and we're all the same. So today, kids, we just want to remind you all that it doesn't treat everybody the same. Love everybody the same. Because that's what Jesus did when he came. He didn't judge. He didn't show anybody, treat anybody any differently. He loved everybody that he was around, no matter who they were or what they were or how they were like.
Mm-hmm. I think that we can always find something special that we really like or get along about somebody next to us.
I agree.
Yeah, if you just look hard enough, you're going to find that you have things in common that you never even dreamed of. So always look for the little common details that you might have with someone else.
I will do that, Auntie M, and we hope you guys do that too. So let us end with prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you, Lord, because you created us in your image, Father. And I just ask that you continue to be with us, Lord, and that when we meet new people, we don't always look on the outside, Father, but we look on the inside and realize, hey, he's just like me, and I'm going to love him all the same. Thank you, Father, for everything that you've done for us, and we ask that you continue to bless us during this time. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
See you guys.